Now let's visit the world's largest, smallest railroad in America.
Wow, that'd be fun.
Couple of engineers.
Yep, yep, yep.
For a steam engine.
Yep.
You know, I know a lot of boys and girls don't know what sundials were and firecrackers.
Okay.
I imagine a lot do not know what steam engines would be.
Oh, they're a lot of fun.
Well, I think they are a lot of fun. And so we've decided to take you to the world's largest, smallest railroad display so that you can get an idea of what trains used to look like. When I say largest, smallest, I mean that it is big, but the things in the display are small. It's a miniature world, and it isn't far from here. It's in a place called Strasbourg. We brought a little bit of the Strasbourg Choo Choo train barn right here to Captain Noah's Ark. If you ever loved playing with railroad trains, this is your opportunity to see them on a grand scale, because I've got a boy with me that grew up to be a man growing with Choo Choo trains, and he couldn't give it up. He decided to make it a lifetime work. And it's so nice to have you here, Tom.
It's nice to be here, Captain Noah.
It really is. You've spent your whole life, really, with choo-choo trains.
Yes, you can honestly say I have grown up with them.
How much railroad track do you have up there in your little layout?
We have over 750 feet of track, and then it's all on a 1,700-square-foot layout.
That's pretty big.
That's pretty big.
In fact, it got so big that you started to invite people in, and now it's open to the public.
Yes, it is. We're open 6 months daily, and then there's 3 months that we're only open on weekends. But during those months that we're open, there's a lot of people come in to see it.
Yeah, the Choo Choo Barn up there in Strasbourg, right off Route 30, about 3 miles off Route 30.
Yeah, right.
Up there to Lancaster, you're almost to Lancaster.
Right.
And what route is that on?
It's on Route 741, and Strasbourg is actually the train capital of the world.
Is it really?
Yes, it is.
Well, we'll let somebody challenge that, by golly. How many trains do you have running all the time up there?
We have 13 operating trains that run simultaneously. Everything runs continuous. Mm-hmm. And there's over 115 different little animated figures and vehicles, which on our display, the trains are actually secondary to our animation. We do a lot of figure and vehicle animation, like you see
airplanes up there.
We have
an alpine ski slope, I know, up there.
Right.
And these are all in miniature.
Right. Everything is based on 1/4 inch to the foot.
Yeah, look at the traffic down there on the highway. That is phenomenal. Look at that.
There's a miniature of Dutch Haven, which is a restaurant in Lancaster County.
Look at that. Look, the traffic out there, a windmill. Now, the interesting thing about this, there we're going up in the car to the mountains, that this all had to be built by somebody.
Right.
And Tom has gotten into building figures. And we thought today, come on over here, Tom. We'll show you how these things are built and how they run. You want to take a look over the phenomenal world of miniature figures and what makes them work. These miniature figures were all done from the very beginning, right?
Right. What happens is we try to make different animated figures and vehicles, and of course there's really nothing that's available commercially, so we had to come up with our own ideas. Now in the front you see the welder where the welding rod touches the piece that he wants to weld, you see a little bit of a welding flash, what looks like welding flash. Okay, now that
Watch that welder come down. That is amazing. Now that's all, you handcrafted all of those.
Right.
Right next to the welder is the playground, and the playground all have figures right here.
Right. That's all?
All done in miniature.
Right.
Now, you even made the little figure.
Now, the figures have to be formed in certain positions. They are commercially available figures, but everything else was made from masters, and then I make all my own molds, cast all my own pieces, or form my own pieces out of brass, and I even brought a mold here along to show you.
Now, look at this over here. We have behind the playground, just go up from the playground, we have a couple of Dutchmen sawing along. And where do you get the ideas for these? Because you're kind of an artist, so you're imitating life, right?
Well, we drive down the road, or we get a lot of ideas from talking to people. They'll say, gee, why don't you have a this, or why don't you have a that? Or a lot of times, like I said, we drive down the road, and if we see something that we think we can animate, we put it in a book.
Look, there's even a fire there, where the firemen are in. How do you do that, with lights?
Yeah, the lights, well, there's a siren that blows. There's smoke that comes out of the house every five. This happens every 5 minutes. Then, when the fire siren rings, the fire engine will actually pull out of the firehouse, come up, and they will put the fire out.
Now, I wanted to show you how this is done. I wanted to show you. Oh, I'll hold it, and Tom Groff will show you how it's done.
Okay. I'll plug it in. This is one that I'm working on for next year to be a new animation to be added. You have to use your imagination now, but there will be a dump truck at the end here, and as the loader goes forward, the bucket goes up, like it would be dumping into the dump truck. Now, as the loader goes back, of course, the bucket will go back down again. That'll be added onto the display for next during the winter for next season.
So you're working on that for next year.
Right.
That is phenomenal. It's a fascinating world in miniature. I thought we'd show you behind the scenes and how it's done at a place up in Strasbourg called the Choo Choo Barn. If you're up there, you say hello to Tom Groff in person. And with the Archipolitan Singers, we all can be working on the railroad.
I've been working on the railroad all the livelong day. I've been working on the railroad just to pass the time away. Don't you hear the whistle blowing? Rise up so early in the morn. Don't you hear the captain shouting? Dinah, blow your horn. Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow your horn?
Coming up next, we're going to find out about the 4th of July after these messages.